Andrew Tate has a gigantic ego, and even that is an understatement. He calls us out for being brokies, wages, and a million other things. He insults everyone who is not on his level, which is pretty much everyone. However, I believe that he's actually earned this ego through sheer hard work, consistency, and intensity. Andrew started from literally the bottom, being homeless in the worst town in England, Luton, to being a multi-millionaire, possibly maybe even a billionaire, with, 30-something supercars, including a beautiful Bugatti Chiron per sports. Andrew Tate is an extremely impressive and powerful physique. He's a 4-time kickboxing world champion. He has fought over like 80 times in professional fights. He has the wealth, the charisma, and the knowledge. He can speak and communicate his point eloquently and effectively. He has an extremely fun lifestyle and an extremely wide range of assets. In other words, in more simple terms, he is what every man should aspire to become. The top potential, their true potential in life. He has become the best version of himself in pretty much all areas and can be taken seriously on whatever he says in most areas in life because he has accomplished amazing things in pretty much all areas. However, this video is not about Tate. Instead, it's about the Tate copycats, the people who use the same buzzwords, the same catchphrases, and have the same aesthetic, the same vibe to their videos. They say the same things, they try to look the same, but they're not really. They use words like brokey and wagey and try to flex on us broke boys. However, they're missing out on one crucial thing to Andrew Tate's success. They've only become amazing in maybe one area of life, while Tate is amazing in many areas of life. Now, they might have made millions of pounds through an online business or a crypto pump, and good for them, they've bought a supercar, and now believe that they are top-tier high-level men who can speak on all areas of life and have people actually listen to them and actually implement what they say into their own lives. But even if you have millions of dollars, but you don't work out, you don't have any skills apart from the ones that make you money, you can't communicate your point, you're embarrassing to watch, and you still look like a weedy little nerd, then people will not listen to you and take you seriously. So also, if you're not trying to improve any of those things, then why should they? And to prove my point, here is someone who has made a lot of money for an online advertising agency, an SMMA, a social media marketing agency. He's extremely successful in that one area of life. However, he has no muscle, no real charisma. He's never went through a struggle or anything. He's only successful in one area of life, and that's it. And I'd like to show you a few clips of him flexing on us, both literally and figuratively.
Ample and me, and we both pull up, and we go to your girl. Odds are, I'm gonna take that bitch. If you compared me to you, you're not gonna win that battle. So the next time you think that your girl's on lock, I got the keys to the castle, motherfucker.
Steal your girl, yeah. I look at my McLaren, bitch. Fucking dork. As you can see, he is extremely successful. He's made enough money to buy a McLaren, a very nice supercar, actually a beautiful car. Yet, I doubt that anything he says in that video are actually true. Unless a woman is a gold digger and only interested in his money, why would she choose this guy? I mean, he's weak, appears very egotistical, and he just seems incredibly awkward and uncomfortable to watch. Like, I don't know any person on the planet who's watched that video and not either laughed or got secondhand embarrassment. I don't think anyone's actually looking at him like, yep, what he's saying is true because he's driving a McLaren. I really don't think so. The main problem with this guy and all the other Tate copycats is they're only successful in one area, yet they try to speak like they're experts in all areas. And it's obvious that this guy's not actually experienced with women or anything else other than just making money. And you can't really say, oh, I'm gonna pull up to any club and I'll just take your girl, if you can't actually back that up. Whilst there's many videos of Andrew Tate pulling up to a club and actually stealing someone's girl. And I think this proves that whilst money is extremely important, it is one of the top three most important things in life, in my opinion. It's not everything. Now, in order to be a high-level, competent man, you should have experience and have gone through struggles in many different areas in life. This is why I believe that exercising and working out is so important, because it literally forces you to struggle, to go through pain, to go to failure, in order to actually grow muscles and become strong, muscular, and aesthetic. But of course, this guy also has plenty to say on exercise and working out, even though he's never worked out a day in his life.
Here's why the gym does not matter. I'm tired of guys that are like, oh, you know, I'm going to the gym, I'm trying to get fit. I feel like I have pretty decent tone. I don't need to go to the gym, hey, because you pull up to the gym, making less than 10K a month, pulling up in your bullshit fucking Corolla, and I pull up in my McLaren. It's not even a contest, dude. No one gives a fuck about your muscles. Most of the guys that go to the gym, I'm sorry to tell you this, but you're fucking stupid. All that pre-workout that you're taking is making you more stupider.
First off, this guy doesn't have good tone on his biceps, whatever that is. I don't know why he's even talking about them. The only person I've ever heard talking about tone is that woman who does those useless weightless curls where you do this. It's just so useless. You cannot build muscle unless you have a sort of resistance against it. And there's no resistance here. Unless you do like 1,000 curls a day, you're not gonna build any muscle or tone anything. Like, even using a water bottle as a weight would be better. But that's going off on a tangent. Now, he's also wrong about exercising building muscle. By building muscle, by becoming stronger, it helps you in so many ways. It helps build your confidence, it helps improve your mental health, decreases stress, make you look more masculine. Other people will respect you more, even if it's subconscious and they don't even notice it. There are literally countless benefits to working out, and I believe it should be a cornerstone, the foundation for any young man, and should be a priority in their lives. Now, if this guy had built a muscular body, I am 100% sure he would not have received half of the amount of hate and negative reactions he did receive. However, getting hate and negative reactions may have actually been his intention with the videos. This guy may have actually acted this insufferably intentionally in order to attempt to blow up on social media and become famous. And if that is the case, then good job, congratulations, you received your 15 minutes of fame, very good job to you. The worst thing is that this guy actually has positive things to say. The message of trying to make more money, trying to get to that 10K per month, trying to actually make yourself independent financially, is a really good message for people who are watching him. However, the way he actually tries to spread that message actually completely failed, because he put money on top of looks, on top of muscle, on top of everything else, and it just makes him look pathetic. So many people want to be like Andrew Tate. However, the thing that people actually like about Tate is that he's authentic, he's real. Now, he might have exaggerated slightly or put on a character sometimes, but he actually struggled and suffered throughout his life and actually became a role model through what he's actually gone through, not the person that claims he's the top G. It's a background, it's a foundation that led him up to that point. Andrew came from a poor background, living with a single mother in some of the most dangerous towns in the world, as I said, in Luton, and also in America, where he lived in Chicago, and he's been stabbed. He's had his life been risked by gangsters. He's been knocked out. He's fought dozens of times professionally. He's won world championships and became a multi-millionaire and one of the most famous and influential people in the world all by himself. Of course, with Tristan standing right next to him and working with him. So, if this guy or any of the other Tate copycats want to actually be the next Top G, or even Aiden Ross, they're actually going to have to put in the hard work actually achieve something beyond just money. Like, it's easy to build up money, especially with online business. However, actually becoming a man who of character, actually achieving things outside of money, is probably harder for him than it is for anyone else. Some people, like, going to the gym is easier. Like, for me, going to the gym is much easier than starting a business and making money. So that's my challenge. His challenge should be going to the gym and maybe, like, starting fighting or something. Challenge himself physically while I challenge myself financially. But essentially, he's trying to skip the hard part, which he actually finds challenging, which is actually the physical parts of building yourself up, and goes right to the supercars and expects people to actually listen to him about anything other than making money. It just doesn't work. You have to have something more than just making money to make people listen to you.